बेटी माँ कभी बॉस बनकर सबके सुख दुख को सहकर अपने सब फर्ज निभाती है, तभी तो नारी कहलाती है। नमस्कार, जय हिंद।
Scripting a new chapter in the history of Air India, an all-women pilot's flight soared over the North Pole through the world's longest air route and landed in Bengaluru from San Francisco on January 11th, covering a distance of about 16,000 kilometers. The inaugural flight AI-176 departed from San Francisco in the USA at 8:30 p.m. local time on Saturday and landed at the Kempe Gowda International Airport in Bengaluru at 3:45 a.m. local time on Monday. Captain Zoya Agarwal, Captain Tanmay Papagiri, Captain Akansha Sonavne and Captain Shivani Manas were among the all-women pilot team to fly the longest commercial flight in the world.
I feel on top of the North Pole. I have rephrased the entire saying of top of the world to top of the North Pole ever since we have created this historic feat in the world record of flying over the North Pole with all four of the Bharat ki betis combined with the, one of the world's longest flight, the world's one of the world's longest flight, and also the longest flight for Air India, the longest flight for any Indian carrier. Connecting the two Silicon Valleys of the US to India, connecting two diametrically opposite city pairs on the planet Earth, the Mother Earth. It was a wonderful feat, and to fly over the North Pole, it was an amazing feeling. I think this flight was the most historic flight I have ever done, and I will clearly remember it along with my 250 odd passengers. That will stay very, very close to my heart because we created records of all sorts in the day. We turned a new leaf in the aviation history today.
The historic flight was commanded by Captain Zoya Agarwal, who has been a pilot with India's national carrier for 17 years now and has flying experience of more than 8,000 flying hours. She has command experience in a Boeing 777 aircraft of more than 10 years and more than 2,000 flying hours. She was also the youngest woman pilot to fly a Boeing 777 in 2013. Despite being backed by such rich experience, one may wonder if there were any butterflies before this landmark journey.
We are pilots. As pilots from day one, when you become a pilot, you are trained to be responsible. You are trained to handle pressure. You are trained to be, you know, aplomb about it, because this is what the whole profession is about, to perform under pressure, because every moment is going to spring a new surprise on you and you have to come up with a viable solution within microseconds, rather nanoseconds, and you don't even have any room for error, because over here the error, if you have, unlike other professions, the price that you pay for that error is your life. So there is no room for error whatsoever. So from the very beginning you're trained to be responsible, and over here also I was already trained for the polar briefing. I'm already a captain on the Boeing 777. I'm experienced. The experienced pilot combined with the right equipment of a Boeing 777, which is a highly reliable aircraft, state of the art. It can connect any two points on the globe. It's a fascinating airplane and a very safe and reliable one. Plus, you have a long checklist of the equipments on board which have to be met, and so on and so forth. The weather has to be conducive, everything has to be perfect. Only then one undertakes such flights. So I think when you go through the whole nine yards of that, all the butterflies calm down, and the responsibility and the panache of it and the confidence of it is what truly shines. And that is exactly what happened yesterday.
The flight, which was the first direct non-stop flight between the two tech cities, understandably would not have been possible if it weren't for all the hard work and preparations.
It's a long preparation. It's not something that happens in one day. It's been carrying out for the last 1 year for me. For the airline, it's been there a long journey for more than a year. It's almost been 1.5 years since we started with the entire crewing flight. And this was the second flight after that commanded by a woman. And also with the three other Bharat Ki Betis, I was flying this amazing journey. So we have been preparing for a very long time. It's been a long and arduous journey, but it's so well worth it considering the rewards. We've been able to create a history of all sorts in Indian aviation, which is indeed fulfilling. So there's a lot of preparation vis-a-vis the equipments that goes in, vis-a-vis the pilot's training, the cabin crew training. There are a lot of tick boxes that have to be checked in. You have to have so many things in order for the polar flight to go ahead. And also that requires the weather gods to be shining upon you that particular day, because if you don't do your prayers well and the weather is not good, you really cannot fly over the pole. So, in fact, last year we were supposed to do this flight, but that got stalled because of the bad weather. There are a lot of parameters for weather which are important and at play in this, which are not otherwise a consideration for normal flights. Having said that, yesterday, when you were very close to our flight, you finally got to know that everything looks good and everything is in order, and the God has been answering our prayers and he's happy with whatever we have been folding our hands to every day. So we finally were able to do the polar, creating world history, connecting the two diametrically opposite points on the globe, and there were four Bharat ki betis doing so. So it was a new chapter in Indian aviation and globally indeed, and definitely a silver lining to a dark cloud in the COVID-19 time especially.
India is extremely happy and proud of the four women pilots who are breaking gender stereotypes one flight at a time. Captain Zoya Agarwal, who has dreamt of being a pilot since she was 8, has only one message to all those women out there.
Nothing is impossible in this world, because every great reality that you want in your life to happen begins with a great dream, and every great dream begins with a great dreamer, and that dreamer lies in you. So don't look back. Nothing is impossible. Stay focused and read I Am Possible.